In order to create a character for lip sync animation, you should probably work in Adobe Illustrator and look up the different lip sync mouth positions through Google image search or different various animation resources. Lip sync mouth positions can be a few or they can be many. The more you have, the more complicated your project's going to get, but the smoother the lip sync will look. For purposes of your beginning lip sync animation, I recommend that you do just a stick figure with basic lip sync positions to try out this technique. Now, before you actually learn lip sync animation and how to do it in Animate CC, it's important to understand how your characters should be set up in a program like Adobe Illustrator to make things go really smoothly when you import them for the frame picker options. So let's go ahead and look at this character. This is a character that I purchased from Adobe Shutterstock. And this character was built a lot of different ways with clipping masks and all that different stuff. And I had to modify her to get down just to the basics. So you can, again, do this with your own drawn character, with a stick figure or something you purchase from a site or some site that has freebies with lip sync mouth positions. So in this particular one, I'll go ahead and shut off the majority of the layers. And the first layer is called Girl. And this is where I have the character's full body. Now, the body can move, it can have different hand positions so that she looks like she's gesturing while she's talking. And most lip sync animations actually have some different face expressions to go with the mouth position, such as the eyebrows moving up and down or inward when they seem frustrated or confused. And that makes a more dynamic lip sync animation. We kept it pretty simple here with just the character's body and the different mouth positions so that you can learn this particular technique. So I'll go ahead and zoom into her mouth, and on each successive layer, you will now see a different mouth position. So we have the smile teeth and the smile line, and these are great for when we don't want her face to look blank, but she's not talking, so she needs to have some sort of mouth expression. Then we have the TH, and this is the mouth position that she would create when she was saying something like that, or the, or thou. I don't know why she would say thou, but there you go. So this is what we would key, or a keyframe we would create for the TH position whenever we hear the phonetic TH sound. So in addition to that, in this particular one, we have CH, J, and SH, the R position, F and V position, Q and W, L, B, M, P, C, D, G, K, N, S, T, X, Z, Y. So this one is really kind of a catch-all. So anytime it doesn't have a particular sound, so to speak, you can use this catch-all one. Then we have the long E or the double E, double O, O, U, and O, and then the A, E, and I. So it's really important when creating your animation file, your Illustrator file or whatever vector graphic program you want to use, it's really important that you name the particular layers based on the mouth movement, and also that you have the mouths stacked right on top of each other so that they still look like they are in the same position but just stretching to different shapes, so to speak. So each one of them needs to have their own particular layer. And then you need to have all of them visible, even though it looks kind of like chaos right now. You need to have them all visible and make sure they're not locked. So we'll go ahead and click File, Save on this, and then we're ready to import it into our Adobe Animate file. So look for that tutorial video on how to create a lip sync animation for the next step in this process.